Hi, this is Azim Hasni. In the previous video, we talked about how we can create PHP router in its simplest possible way. So I have seen multiple questions regarding how we can add dynamic routes to this router. Since we're looking for a very simple approach, so we didn't introduce anything that's that complicates this router. So in this episode, I have decided to talk about or show you guys how we can add dynamic routes to this router. What I mean by dynamic routes is, for example, currently this only has two routes. If you go to the slash route, it just returns this string. And if you go to the about route, you get the same or similar string in your browser, for example. But now I'm on the home page. If I go to about, you'll see the response from that route. But what if I want to say I want to have a route called company slash, for example, Google? Okay, so right now it obviously won't work, so we need to add some code to handle that, or you'll see some notices and warnings because that needs to be handled. So how we can add dynamic routes so something like this works as well? This can be anything. This is a dynamic value. This can be Facebook, or this can be whatever, like Tesla, right? So let's dive into the code. Yeah, so now I'm gonna add another route here. Let's say I'm gonna call this something like this, route. Base path is company, and then I want anything after that. Okay, and the last question mark is optional, so I'm gonna add a question mark for it. What we want is whatever the value is in here, we want that to be as the first argument of this function. So I'm gonna call this, I'm gonna call this company name. Okay, so as you can see, if you're not familiar, this is regular expression. Okay, so what we are doing here, we're saying we want a string that starts with slash company slash, and then we want anything after that. It can be a digit, a character, or any special characters can go here. Okay, and after that we are expecting a slash, but that's optional. If it's not there, this will still match as the current action. Okay, so let's return the company is company name. All right, now what we need to change in our router to handle a route something like this. So first of all, let's look at the routes array. This, what this does is takes the action and just stores it in the global routes array, so we don't need to change anything here. This can stay as is. So I'm gonna skip that and come here. What we are doing here, when we receive the action, we first of all remove any slashes from the start and the end of the string, and then try to find that inside the routes global array. We are trying to find it by the index. Okay, so if our routes error looks something like about, and this is the callback. So it's gonna just match this particular string, and then we'll get the callback here, which we can call on line 35. But we no longer want that, because right now we wanna support regular expressions in our action names. So I'm gonna disable this line for now and set the callback to null. And since our callbacks can now accept multiple number of arguments, so I'm gonna say params is equal to an empty array for the time being. Okay, what we can do next is we need to iterate through all the routes one by one. So I'm gonna add a for each loop routes as route. So since the key is our action, so I'm gonna call this route, and the value is our callback, so I'm gonna call that handler. Okay, and we need to check if this if the current action matches the regular expression that is stored inside the routes variable. So what we can do to match any regular expression stored inside this route variable, we'll use PHP's prag match function, and this accepts three arguments. First is the regular expression itself. The second parameter, if you see, is the subject, which is the action, and the third parameter stores any matches found inside that that string, that subject. So I'm gonna store that as matches. Okay, so let's build our regular expression. So first I'll need to add 2% signs. These are special delimiters. You can add any character that is allowed. So I'm gonna say start of the string, end of the string, and then our route. To be safe, I'm gonna put this in curly braces. All right, so right now, if this is equal to, so this function returns three values. It either returns 0, false, or 1. In case of any matches, it returns 1. In case of an error, it returns false. And in case it doesn't match, then it returns 0. So I'm gonna strictly check for 1. In this case, that means our current action matches the current route, which is in the for each context. So we don't need to check any of the routes. So the first action that matches any of the routes, we're gonna stop there. So let's break the loop here. And then I'm gonna set our callback to handler, which is coming from here, and I'm gonna set parameters to matches. Okay, and there's one minor catch that we need to take care of, is the matches, the first element of the match, we don't need that, so we need to unset. First index, we don't need the 0th index, so we're gonna remove this. Okay, that's the matching part. so we don't need this anymore. So let's remove it. And we need to tweak this a little bit. And we're gonna say, so anything that is stored inside this params array will be passed as the parameters to our callback. Alright, so this company name comes from this params array. Okay, so if we have done everything correctly, this should work. So let's try this. The company is Tesla. If we change this to Facebook, the company is Facebook. Or if you change it to Google, the company is Google. So with this simple logic, we can add more complex routes without changing any of this logic here. So let's try a more complex route. So let's say /users/user name is dynamic, and then for example city, and city of the user. Okay, and now our function accepts multiple parameters. So I'm gonna name this one as the username, and the other one is going to be the city. So I'm gonna say city. Okay, so I can return username lives in city. Okay, so let's see if this works. Say user/John and then city is London. Okay, so this needs to be users. Okay, so now it works. John lives in London. So what about that? I just saw this, so what if there's a typo? Okay, so what if this is user? We are receiving this error, so we need to handle some sort of 404 logic to our router. So I could make this another video, but I think it's simple enough that I should add it here. So let's say if there is no callback, if not callback, or the callback is not callable, what is callable? Okay, so I'm gonna first of all kill the script execution, and I'm gonna also set the HTTP response code to 404, and then send some sort of feedback to the user. This, you can handle this like in many different ways. So I'm gonna keep it simple and just add it here. You can like throw an exception here and then catch that exception in your where you dispatch your router here, and based on the exception you can like render different views. So I'm gonna keep it simple and say 404 not found. Okay, so let's see, instead of this error we should receive a nice 404 not found error, and our browser should also receive a 404 status code from the server, which is the case. So I think that's it. I hope you have learned how to tweak the same exact router to handle dynamic routes. and I hope this was useful for you. My intention is to just to teach you the concepts. So this, I hope you won't use this in production. In production, there are lots of good routers that are well tested. They are battle tested in production, so you can use one of them instead of like building your own. But for learning purposes, I think it's good to build your own stuff piece by piece to learn the core concepts. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel.